Good morning, all of you. So today we will discuss questions related to the story that we have recently completed. Very interesting story. And today we shall discuss short questions and descriptive questions regarding the story that we have completed. So till now we were discussing original text of the story word to word, and that we have done. Now we have completed the reading task of the story. Now we will have to understand the story, and now it is a test that we have understood it or not. And story is also interesting because it provides a very good vocabulary list. There are some words which as a student you must learn. So we will also discuss important words that occur in the story, starting with the short questions. Okay, it will be very interactive session if you could answer. Okay, in your chat box you can answer this question. Who is Albert Edward? Okay, very good. One reply. Okay, so in a written examination, can a question like this occur? Who is Albert Edward? So your answer should be that Albert Edward is a verger at the St. Peter's. This is the name of a church, St. Peter's, where it is Naval Square in London. Who is the author of the Virgil? The story, the version. write name of the author in chat box. William Somerset Maugham. Very good. So the author, short story writer of the story The Verger is Somerset Maugham, is the author of The Verger. Okay, William Somerset Maugham, that is the full name. What does it mean? Verger means, in short, if you have to tell, short ma tamara kevu hoy, meaning of the word verger. What does the word verger means? Albert Edward is a verger. In the story The Verger by Somerset Maugham, in which, what does the word verger mean? Very good. It is caretaker in church. The word verger means an official caretaker in a Christian church. Means he is supposed to take care of small things inside the church. Taking care of small things inside the church. Okay, very good. How long has Albert Edward working at his job? For how long years? How many years? Very good. For 16 years. How you have to write? Albert Edward working at his job for 16 years. Albert Edward has been working at his job for 16 years. So these are the very small details that you have to remember for short questions in examinations. These are also important for MCQ purposes. This may occur in an MCQ form. Where does he work, The Verger? Answer in the chat box. Where does The Verger work in the story? St. Peter's Neville Square Church in London. Very good. Neville Square is the location. Name of the church is St. James Peter's in London. So the answer is, The Verger works at St. Peter's Neville Square in London. you have to write all these questions in your notebook. Sub questions, descriptive questions, and important words. Now, next questions. Where is St. Peter's Church is located? What is your answer? Where the church is located? Yes. So the answer is St. Peter's Church is located. P should be in capital. It is typographical error. Please take note, St. Peter, P should be capital. It is a proper noun. So St. Peter's Church is located at Neville Square. So it is located at Neville Square in London. Next question. What was the Varjas gown made of? In the first paragraph of the story, there is a mention of Varjas gown. Perennial bronze is a one type of metal. Perennial is a long lasting. So it was made up of perennial bronze. Okay, what is the meaning of this word pastry? Pastry means yes. Room for keeping vestments, vessels, and records. Yes. Or in a yes, meeting purpose. Vestry is a meeting room or a room attached to a church used to keep vessels and to hold meetings. Then next question. Okay, where has the new vehicle come from? The new vehicle has come from, very good, east and yes, very good. So the new vicar in the story has come from East End. What weakness does the verger have? What is the verger's weakness? What is the weakness of the verger? What type of weakness he has in this story, the verger? The verger doesn't know reading and writing. Otherwise, he is a very skillful person. He is a talented person, but the only weakness that he has is reading and writing. What kind of a new business set up by Berger? After leaving search, what type of business the verger chooses? What he becomes after leaving St. Peter for a lifetime? Answer in the chat box. Jai Nagrani, Mahek Modi, Ketu Shah. Yes, topic honest and news agent. Very good. So after resigning the post as a verger and resigned Naval Square, the verger started a new business as a opaconist and news agent. Started a new business as a opaconist and news agent. Very good. Now next question. What does the bank manager come to know about Albert Edward? Okay, at the end of the story, when Albert Edward meets manager, they are sitting in manager's office. So what is it? Something strange, unusual that he comes to know. The manager comes to know about Albert Edward. He was surprised. So what was that matter? That is fine, that is he knew. That was surprising matter. Bank manager knows that how much money he has, you know, deposit in his account. But he was surprised to know that the person who has this large amount of money in his account, he doesn't know reading and writing, he was illiterate. That was surprising matter. So after meeting personally the butcher, Albert Edward, the manager comes to know this mysterious thing about Albert Edward. He just wanted to suggest Albert Edward that you have plenty of money available. You should invest in share marketing rather than deposit in the bank. Because where you will get, there you will get more interest rate. But he was surprised to know that the person he is giving advice, you know, unable to read and write. So the bank manager comes to know that Albert Edward has become successful in business without being able to read and write. That is the matter. He comes to know that the person doesn't know reading and writing. So without being able to read and write, he becomes a successful businessman. You can take screenshot if you want to. What was Albert Foreman's profession? Now it is descriptive question. Descriptive questions means you have to write answer in a paragraph. Up to now we were talking about, we saw short questions just within a one or two lines. Now descriptive question means you have to describe question. Describe means in a paragraph. So when a descriptive question is asked, first thing that you have to do is in the first line that you have to mention the name of the story and name of the author. You can mention at the beginning of your answer that Albert Foreman is a verger in a St. Peter's Navy Square in the story The Verger by Somerset, written by Somerset Maugham. And then about his characteristic, you can mention, add some. So how you can write? This is, I have already given to you this material, it is available in the Google Classroom. So the questions which are there, 5 to 6 questions in the material which is there in the Google Classroom, the same questions I am going to just show you in the slide. Therefore, show story we study in order to improve our language skill, how we can construct answer. Once we have understood the story, every character and every aspect regarding the story, then now we should be able to explain it or write about it. So when you are asked to describe the Albert Edward Foreman's profession, you can describe in this way. So this is the answer in the one paragraph. So Albert Foreman was the verger of St. Peter's Church, Neville Square. You can also add London. So it is flexible, it is not fixed. You can also make your answer more effective, better than this. So don't stick to this answer only. You can develop your own way of answering. He had been working as a verger for 16 years. You can mention this. He started his career as a page boy. His profession is asked about Albert Edwards. Before he joined church as a verger, he was page boy. Then he became first footman from the fourth, and then worked as a butler, chief servant, aristocratic houses. Aristocratic means very wealthy houses, rich people's houses. And Foreman took pride in having in being a verger of a sophisticated church. Sophisticated means very reputed, especially for aristocratic, rich, wealthy people, for sophisticated people. St. Peter's, Neville Square, was located there. So this is how you can answer this question. In a format, F should be capital in answer. Please take care note of this. Proper noun always have the first letter always should be a proper noun, capital. So this is how means he started his career as a page boy, then a footman, and as a butler. Three words you have to remember: page boy, footman, and butler. In different houses. And when he joined church, last time he was butler in one of the ambassador's house. Two people working under him. Butler means chief servant. And under him, few other servants are working. So, this is how Verger made progress in his life. Going to next question, what kind of person is Albert Foreman? Now it is about his nature, that means characteristic, quality as a person. Albert Foreman was a sincere worker. We come to know by reading story that he is very sincere, doing his duty very honestly. So sincere, who did his duty very well, that we come to know in the story. He was so honest and gave a long and faithful services for 16 years at the St. Peter's Church. He never caused any inconveniences to others. There was no problem related to him. He fulfilled his duties to the satisfaction of everybody concerned in the church. He did his duty very well, sincerely. And everybody in the church were satisfied with his duty. Foreman held himself high during difficult times. Very good, yes, very good point, yes. Yeah, your answer should be always spontaneous. Yes, you can write in your very excellent. So, everything related to whatever you know about his character, you can mention. So, sincere, honest, these are the words suitable for Verger. He didn't allow the vicar to put him down. He knew his value of hence didn't accept the proposal of learning to read and write. He refused. Vicar was saying, Varjit, that we are giving you 3 months if you could learn, but he denies. He thinks that it is better because self-worth is given here importance. So Varjit thinks that better not to believe in Vicar. Instead of believing Vicar's proposal, he prefers to resign. So he didn't like the Vicar and he spoke in a respect to him and didn't express his dislike or dissatisfaction. In a way, he doesn't like the Vicar, but he does not express his dislike and dissatisfaction. So he remained very silent and humble when actually he felt like being humiliated. Chare, meeting my nahi rite jar humiliate karwa mayo virtual man. But he remained calm, relaxed. But he knew his strength. So he identified his strength and became a successful businessman. All in all, we can say that Foreman is a man with a great self-respect. He is a polite man who is able to compose himself. It means he knew himself that how to handle his personal life. Nobody else can tell me what should I do and not. So self-worth is important. So he doesn't believe Vicar. Instead, he believes in himself. This is the reason he became successful. So self-worth, self-respect, politeness, faithfulness, sincere worker, willpower, these are the points that you can add in this answer of this question pertaining to descriptive questions. The next question: what kind of person is Albert Foreman? Same. What are Foreman's feelings about the new vicar? From the beginning, Berger did not like the new vicar. Okay, Foreman never liked the new vicar. Thought that they made mistake. Such people have made mistake after voting him as a merchant. And the vicar was not a man suitable for the classy people that come to the St. Peter's Church to pay share. Yahan ke log always sophisticated, classy people. This vicar is not suitable for them. And it is a new appointed and it is not yet adjustable to the fashionable congregation. He is a learning things and he also interferes in every issue. Being a vicar of the church, he interferes in every issue, which makes Foreman impatient. This makes a little uncomfortable. Because Varjar politely was looking after everything. There was no need to interfere in his work or any matter of the church. But Vicar was doing from the time he joined the church as a Vicar. Therefore, there was a dislike. So this is the relation between Varjar and Vicar of the church. This is the answer of the question. This question can also be asked in this way, if I put in other words, that what is the opinion of Berger about new vicar? So this is his opinion, that the people have made a mistake after appointing this new vicar, and new vicar is not suitable for this church. Okay, next. Why does the new vicar want four men to leave position, his position only? Because he doesn't know reading and writing. Let us read out his answer. The new vicar says that a reputed church like St. Peter's, you know, cannot have an illiterate version. So he says that they can't take the risk of some accident that may happen because of verger's ignorance. Ignorance means not knowing reading and writing. So it is the matter of church reputation. Because in the future, if people will come to know that the verger working in the church, that person doesn't know reading and writing, he is illiterate. Then, so the vicar wants foreman to learn, read and write within 3 months. But as a foreman is reluctant. Reluctant means not willing to learn. He refuses, and vicar has asked him to leave his position. He strongly believes that an illiterate, vicar believes that illiterate person cannot be a verger of reputed church. And this is why the new vicar makes foreman the verger leave his position. Because he thinks that the church is reputed, where verger not being able to read and write cannot work here. What happens when foreman walks out of the church? The church mati jai se chare sung bane se. Foreman is occupied with thoughts, deep thinking is going on in his mind. He didn't know what is going to come. He is uncertain about his future, what will happen next. So he is totally uncertain about his future. He has no enough money. He lost his job as a verger. And he is not sure of his future. So he finds that he is ill-treated for being an illiterate. Okay, so he was humiliated by vicar and other people near to church wardens of the church. So in this state of mind, the things were going on in his mind, and he locks the church door and starts walking slowly across the square. He is so sad that he doesn't go the lane, that means the road, the path that he has to go that leads to his house, but he takes a wrong turn, different turn, and keeps walking with a heavy heart. And he finds himself in a long street filled with shops on either side. Lot of shops are available in the streets, but he wants to relax himself, therefore he wants a cigarette, but he doesn't find cigarette. So this is what happens after leaving the church. And a little later he searches for a cigarette shop, but it doesn't find one. And it then strikes him that he can also start a business of selling tobacco, because no shop selling tobacco was available at the location. So he grabs this opportunity that here we can start a new venture, and he does it and gets success in it. How he expands his business? Within a month he buys a shop, then two shops, and within a 10 year, 10 shops. So foreman starts his life as a tobacconist after he gets relieved as a verger. Verger profession showed in a sheet. Tobacconist business start courage, and in a year he is able to make good money, and he starts another shop and in another lane, BG Coast Street one, and he appoints a manager there in the second shop. Then he thinks that he can run more shops if he is able to run more than one. So whenever he finds time, he walks the long lanes of London and long streets of London, searching a street where there is no tobacco shop available. So then he starts another shop there, and this way he is able to expand his business, and he becomes the owner of 10 shops इन स्पान ऑफ 10 ईयर्स, बराबर 10 वर्ष के अंदर ही बिकम्स द ओनर ऑफ 10 शॉप्स. सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम जस्ट वन लिटिल शॉप, देन टू शॉप्स, एंड स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली, आफ्टर विच ही सर्च द लोकेशन एवरी स्ट्रीट, व्हेनेवर ही फाउंड राइट प्लेस एंड शॉप अवेलेबल देयर, ही स्टार्टेड देयर स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली. विद इन 10 ईयर्स ही बिकेम ओनर ऑफ 10 शॉप्स. Now discussion at the end between the bank manager and foreman. This is the last question, and then we will end the class. So very simple. The bank manager suggests the foreman that invest in this stock because there is a huge money in his account because of the high interest rate. So, but foreman says that he knows nothing about the stocks and shares. He has no idea of this, stocks and share marketing, but just politely answers. And the bank manager offers him help, but Berger tells that he would select the stocks for foreman. Now manager says that he would look after everything for foreman's sake, and he just has to sign. But foreman expresses his doubt about how he would know what he is going to sign because he is unable to read the document. The banker says that he simply has to read and write, but foreman reveals his secret that he doesn't know how to read. And the bank manager is then surprised after listening this, that foreman, being an illiterate, able to earn a fortune. So he likes to know what he would have become had been the educated. So that he educated ho. लगता वंस आवड तू तो सो बने और यू पूछे जे बैंक मैनेजर ने. फॉरमैन रिप्लाइज दैट ही वुड हैव बीन अ वर्जर फॉर द सेंट पीटर्स नेव स्क्वायर चर्च. वो पता से वर्जर वो किया. ओके, देन वी विल डिस्कस इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. थैंक यू फॉर अटेंडिंग क्लास. हैव अ नाइस डे. टाइप योर रोल नंबर इन द चैट बॉक्स. आंसर्स आर अवेलेबल विद यू. गो थ्रू देम अगेन. रीड दीज आंसर्स ट्वाइस.